We have to understand that delegation is a process, and we can't delegate all of the things on our plate at the exact same time. It's similar to climbing a mountain. You know, when you think about climbing a mountain or achieving that goal of getting to the top of the mountain, somebody doesn't just get to the top of the mountain by chance. Somebody doesn't just end up and say, man, look at me. I climbed a mountain. I hadn't trained at all for it. I didn't have the supplies for it, and I had no support, but I just decided one day I was going to go up and climb the mountain, and here I am. No, that's not how it works. When somebody makes the decision to climb a mountain, there's preparation, there's planning, there's supplies, there's support, there's encouragement, and there is a game plan in place. That is what delegation is. You've got to find the first smallest piece of something that you could delegate. What is the first thing that you can move off your plate and onto someone else? Because then, when you go to the first thing, you can start taking the next step. What is the next thing you can move off of your plate? So through the course of this session today, we are going to identify what is your first thing. So to do this, I need you to grab a piece of paper and a pen, and we're going to figure out where to start together. The first question that I want you to write down on the top of your paper is simply this. What are three things that only you can do as a service manager? What are the three things that no one else in your department can do? Maybe for you, it's calling your customers with quotes on complex orders. Maybe for you, one of the things is making sure that after a customer has an order, you pick up the phone and make sure that they are happy and satisfied with their order. Maybe for you, it's setting the text schedules for the next day. But what are the three things that only you can do as a service manager? I want to caution you on this. There are certain things that you might think that only you can do, but maybe it's because of an emotional tie. Maybe you're like so many of our service managers, and that you came up to a service manager position from starting as a service coordinator. Then you moved to a tech, then possibly a service writer. And here you are today as a service manager, a general manager, an owner, whatever it is. And you look back at the things that you used to do, things that you used to love to do. Maybe you love to change oil on the products that you carry. Maybe there is something that you love to do, but it's not something that only you can do. Is there something on your list of the three things that only you can do that's there because of emotional ties? Because it was your baby at one point. It was something that you put your blood, sweat, and tears in, and the idea of moving it off your plate onto someone else's plate is hard. Now, if that's the case, I want you to take it off. And I want you to write down the three things for your service department that only you can do.